So why did you go to India?
You know, for me, it was a personal as much as professional decision. My dad, you know, being born and raised there, and my mom is, you know, East Coast American. The culture was very familiar to me. All my cousins and aunts and uncles moved here when I was a kid. They were all, you know, full Indian, and culturally it was very, I grew up with the movies playing in the house and the food cooking on the stove. And so I had always wanted to explore living there. And I had a trip, I guess, in, it was 2006, where I showed Waterborne there and started to realize, you know, wait a second, the Hindi film market is one of the largest in the world. And, you know, I'm in that business. Is there a way to put these two things together? And so I went out there, again, just telling myself I would give a year. And it ended up being 3 years, but spread out over some time. And it's been a pretty exciting journey.
And that, those 3 years also led you to make this film, The Ashram.
Yeah.
Which means the monastery.
Yeah.
In some ways. So let's take a quick look at The Ashram and okay. Come back and talk about it.
All right.
So those who seek are welcome.
And what is it you seek?
Truth.
The truth takes time, my friend.
You certainly don't take no for an answer.
I'm Jamie.
Chandra.
So what made you become a seeker?
Maybe you knew a friend of mine. She passed through here a while back. Her name's Sophie.
Agurti has been reincarnating for thousands of years.
Do you know why you are here? You are here because you know something.
There is something so beautiful happening here. This mountain is the gateway to another realm.
Okay, so we saw a clip from The Ashram, which was shot entirely in India, where the Himalayas are actually like a character.
Yes.
Because you've shown the Himalayas like I've never seen before.
Oh, that's awesome.
How did you come up with the idea to make this film?
I'm a product of two cultures. You know, my mom is American, my dad is Indian. So any stories that are at the intersection of the two cultures really speak to me personally. And I guess, you know, in a lot of ways, the first port of entry for people understanding India from the West is through spirituality, and whether it be yoga or the mythologies, people really think of India as a spiritual place from the West. And so naturally in my first journeys there, it was, you know, sort of understanding where the Beatles went and like how this Rishikesh
okay.
came into the picture, because that was the yoga capital of the world, and that's where the Beatles found their yogi. And so
Steve Jobs also went to that part of the
yes,
world.
Yes, and people say that's where he had the idea for Apple, was
yes.
on his journey.
He says he found Indians to be the most intuitive.
Is that right?
I think that's what he said, yeah.
Wow. Well, he's right. No, I guess in that way, it's such a different way of looking at the world. And there's definitely a sense of family and a sense of identity and a sense of just faith that I don't think that the West has is adopting, but isn't there inherently. And I think for me, going to Rishikesh and sort of seeing a lot of people that had come to find themselves, or at least, you know, begin the journey, it was a really exciting mix of cultures. And at the same time, rife with drama, because people that come out there, there's sort of a spiritual tourism that's packaged for them, and there's, you know, while there's as much good that can come out of that journey, there's also a lot of danger and darkness that's associated with it. And so it was, I guess I was at one of the aarties on the river, and I saw this European woman dressed in full Indian salwar kameez, and I was like, what's her story? Like, what brought her here? What does she believe?